All right, good afternoon, my dear everyone. I want to thank you for your chance and your time for coming here today and to also once again make out your time to review what we have here. All right. The question we have before us today to answer is 2008. This question we have already answered them before. In fact, it was the first question I answered when I began this series. But you know, a lot of people are subscribing to the channel and my channel, and they are watching. And somewhere there were suggestions, especially the first one where I presented it, and some other observations that we have found not to be okay. So I was advised to review the entire video and see whatever I'm going to do to make some corrections in them. This video was designed, it's designed now. I designed this one purely to meet that requirement. And particularly, I want to use this opportunity to appreciate Mr. Togbe, who is a chief examiner with NECO. He has been following my work all this time, and he has seen what I've been doing, and he was impressed with it. So he made some additional suggestions on what you can do to make a better presentation for the 2008 question. All right, that is what has informed this, and other ones that people, more other viewers have also suggested. I'm taking that into consideration now to make sure that I review this. So what you have before you now is really an updated version of the formal 2008, which I have already deleted before I uploaded this one. So as we go into this particular moment, I will be very, very impressed if you can be able to follow along together with us and get this information pass across. And then please share this particular video, subscribe to it if you have not subscribed to it. Click the notification button, and then also we can be able to like our channel so that we can have more of what is more important. Whenever any other video is being released, you can be able to, as a matter of reality, get the information passed on to you. So as we go now, please, I want to welcome you to this session of our updated and upgraded version of 2018, you know, WAEC Technical Drawing Objective Question. Thank you. Now, the page you just saw that I moved before now was what you see the moment they give you a sheet of paper, and then that will make it to the end. That's where you see the rules and the instructions you will follow. I strongly believe that before now you must have known how to see, you have seen those kind of things before. Now, the page I see now is what you're going to see once you flip the first page into the next page of the book. You will see this, and here you are giving an example of a question. How to answer it is shown here. So, the part of the building immediately above. Window frame is what the answer of this one is C. It's a C, and then they show you how to answer it here. So please stick to this because these answers placed inside square brackets, they are a kind of too close. And if you don't shade it well, then you mix and then you know, affect the next one. And your marker might think, you know, you have shaded the wrong one. Cancel the mark to that. So for this reason, let's be very careful as we proceed now. Okay. Question session A. This session A is made up of 30 questions. The majority of things we're going to see, they are things we'll be learning from even JS1 to SS3. And then some of the things you see in geometry, geometric constructions, and everything like that, plane geometry, and all that things, as well as lighter aspects of building drawing and machine drawing. You will see some question design around them under this. And then after the 30th question in section B, you will see two options given. That's how WAEC does it. Where you see the A part, the number one part of section B has to do with building drawing, and the number two has to do with what, machine drawing. So let's go on. Reduce template is used for what? The answer to number one is not, is the smooth curve through point that do not lie. If I went joining points, use reduce template to do that. Which we normally call French curves, as we need to use to join distance properly. It makes it a journey by joining the points 3, 3. All right, join the first three. And then when you arrange this template to join the first three, Then when you want to count the first three, the last point of the first 3 points becomes the first point for the next 3 points. And that's the pattern. You join that. That is how it is done. Now, question number two. The thin line used to ensure uniformity in height of letter in lettering is what? The answer is simply C, guideline. The distance between these thin lines is just about 4 millimeters wide. So we use them to do freehand writing when we never do something. Question number three. Which of the following figure does not have redundant dimension, that does not have redundant dimension, excess dimension? If you check A option, A, 5 repeated itself, describing the same feature, 20 repeated itself, describing the same feature, 45 here is describe the same feature, but D, no any dimension is repeated. So the correct answer here is D. All right. Now, number four, in representative fraction, the ratio of the numerator to denominator is given what? The answer is A. The answer to this one is A. It shows the ratio of the drawn size to the natural size of the object. This ratio of the size of the drawn size to the natural size of the object. That's why it is written. The answer is A. Number five, now there's a small calculation here. They say interior angle of a regular nonagon is what? The interior angle of a regular nonagon. Now, how do you get? Nonagon has 9 sides, all right? Now, for you to get the exterior, not interior, exterior angle. You see, to get the interior angle, you need to subtract the exterior angle from 180 degrees to get the interior angle. And to get the exterior angle, you need to divide. You know, 360 by the number of sides of the polygon. So since we have, this thing, the number of sides of this nonagon to be 9, so we divide, 360 divided by 9. What we have is 40. Now when you subtract this 40 from what? 180, the answer will become D. This is the interior angle of a nonagon. Answer is D. Now, this particular figure we have here is to be used to answer questions number 6 and number 7. Let's proceed. The angle, now look at the diagram I have by the side here. See the angle PST, the angle PST, what type of angle it is? It's what? It's an obtuse angle. The angle is what? It's A. The correct angle is A. The value of angle RPS, actually the correct answer is 50. Just simply subtract what 40 from 90, because 90 plus, from the other 90, if you look at the figure, the diagram we have here, you will see that we are given 40, which is the exact copy of the angle at Q is same as the angle at S, because the line connecting QP as well as PS, they are the same length. So this is a triangle from more like a kind of isosceles triangle. So the angle we're going to have at P, RPS is going to be 90 minus 40, which is 50. The correct answer here is B. Number 8. It says a triangle whose sides are in ratio 3, ratio 4, ratio 5 is what? It's scaling triangle B. The answer is B. Right, number 9, we are given a figure here. We say in triangle JLK, shown in figure 2, line JP is what? The answer is altitude. The answer is D. Please do not be offended if you are hearing noise in the background. Lectures are going on downstairs. And I couldn't have a quiet time to do this now because of extensive academic work. You kindly bear with me for the shouts and hearing noise you're hearing. The students seem to be on break or something outside. Number 10. How many faces has a tetrahedron? A tetrahedron is a plane figure that is a plane shape, no figure. Let's shape the house prophecies made up of triangles. So you can see the answer here is 4, 4, which is A. Number 11, a line within a circle and touching two points on the second press without passing through the center of the circle. The answer is B, is core. Core does not touch the center of the circle. Now, number 12, the application of the principle of tangency, circle, and line is found in what? The answer is simply C. We use principle of tangency to construct ball easily. That is that. So, the answer is C. Now, figure number, question number 13. Question number 13 is the construction. The construction shown in figure 3 will produce what? Nothing but what? Circumscribed circle around a triangle. How? You can see the circle. The answer is a circle passing through the point J, K, L. In fact, if you connect J and L, you're going to have a triangle. Meaning this circle is going to go round this particular place, round like this, and get back to this place, touching the three places. So it is a kind of circumscribed triangle. Number 14, they say that the locus of a point on the circumference of a circle, as the circle moves without slipping along a straight line, is what? The answer is cycloid. The answer is cycloid. Now, question number 15. We are going to use the figure given here, figure 4, to answer questions 15 and question 16. We have to use that to answer question 15. And question number 16. Now, you see, let us now proceed to see how the questions look like. Number 15, the path labeled T is what? The path labeled T in the diagram that sits on the screen, please. The diagram, the path labeled T is the vertex. The answer, therefore, is D. The vertex is the point where the curve reaches and the turn and curves back, right? Number 16, if F is 15, then E is what? E is what? It's also 15. By the eccentricity, we are told the eccentricity of parabola is 1, meaning the distance from the directrix to this parabolic line and from the parabolic line to the focal point are the same. So when you divide these two, the answer will be 1. So if F is 15, then automatically, you will do what? 15. The answer is C. Now we have to use the diagrams above. There are two similar triangles to answer question number 17 and question number 18. Now consider the diagram placed by the side. You can see something here. But the two sides similar to each other are what? Is RS and NY. These are the sides that are parallel, that are similar to each other. So the correct answer is B. Question number 18. The two angles similar to each other are what? Is RN and R and N. These angles are the same. They are the same with each other. Now, this diagram we have on the screen is to be used to answer three questions, 19, 20, and 21. And because of the nature of the question, we will need videos to answer these questions appropriately. So, question number 19 is coming up. So watch out how this question will be answered now.
All right, now this question, the diagram we have on the board is tagged figure 6. And we have to use the diagram to answer three questions, namely number 19, number 20, and number 21. Now, let's begin with number 19. A symmetric view of the object is shown. So four options are there, as you can see it on the screen. Let us see how out of these four, we can arrive at the correct answer. These are the two places given to us to convert them to isometric. We need the isometric axis, which is always like this, normally like this, right? So with the help of this axis now, I can take this one and place it here, which makes it to be something like this. Alright, this is so I can have this one now. Then I can enter this particular one here, this hole under it. And I will remove this one because there's no line here. And we have line here. So this particular one has to do with this. What do I mean? Consider this line is not seen. This particular line is not visible. The line here tells me how deep this hole goes into this object. The same way this line to here tells me how far this particular hole goes to run from the beginning. In fact, just let's start from the beginning to the end. In that case, we are about to have a situation where I can draw this place down here, and then draw this place down here. Let me also enter those lines here to represent this one, which has a copy of the way to the end, and a copy of the other one to this way, which I can say at this moment, all right, this line is no more visible because it was a sign. That is why they say dash line, all right. Then this one too has a copy outside that come here and grow, which if I take this one, it's going to take me something like this. And then this one to run this way, that can come this one and come up. So I will have something this way that will join this one here. Now I can now remove this. It's clear now that this line will have actually this one. So it's going to become this thick. And then this one will come down here and meet one. So this one can go. This one now will be able to become visible. And this one this way. So that this one now is now visible and we have something of this thing too. I can remove these other hidden lines to allow the object in its full way based on height it's drawn. So a copy of this line, which is this one, alright, covered by this line, has its own copy here. In fact, I can put this and just draw this one like this. So there's no need to have this hidden line because in the absence of the hidden lines, we are not sure. So in this case, you can see that the object, I can complete it here now and put it this way. You can now see the object we have here, the correct answer for this one is A.
Take note of how this decision for the answer here will be taken now.
Now, that is it. Then, question 20. The oblique view is the oblique view of this. How do you get oblique view? Simple. You just convert the oblique axis. Get the oblique axis. Get the oblique axis of this one. And how do I do that? Let me remove this. The oblique axis is like this. So since we assume that this is a front view, because this one is C, this is the end view, I take it as a front view based on the way the options were arranged. So we can copy this place like this. Now like this, have it this way. Right, this one now will be here. Okay, it's going to be somewhere here. And now this scroll at the top. Now open up this place. Give me this one. And still fly out this like this way. And this one goes up like this. This man, alright, we have something like that, and then this one will come up and complete it for us. You can see from this sketch, rough sketch here, that we have an object which you can make like this. This line that I draw now is this line, alright, this line in oblique form, okay? So you are not going to have a very, very funny sketch of this thing to look like this, alright? Something like that. Now, you see, this is the oblique form of this object. And if you look at this object very well, the correct answer here would be what? The correct answer would be. The correct answer for this one is not B. Reason is because B does not have this. The correct answer is C.
Also, watch out how the answer here will be selected now.
Are you getting it? And that is it. And the last question, question 21. Say the plan view is, when drawing the plan view, we are told to come back to the front view first. Where we choose the front view. In that case, this line, become vertical lines. All of them become like this. Become like that. This one. Then I will choose this other one, this two. namely this one and this one together with this other side. Then the one inside, the one comes, since it's not visible from the top, plan view. And then with this, we can conclude that the answer for number 21 is A.
More so, question 22. I don't know if they have a diagram above. Please, to be able to decide which answer is correct, here we need a little video illustration. So follow the video that comes out for now.
All right. Now, question 22 says, figure 7 shows two unequal square prisms. The line of intersection is what they want us to show here. So this place I give you, just this is how you get the line of intersection. Just draw a line from this depth and tank it up to tell you that the limit to which the line of intersection is. Since the other nodes is like this, and then I stop here as the question was given. This line I give you the point where this one can reach. For this moment, you can now connect this one and connect this one. That is it. The answer comes out to be A. Thank you.
Question number 22. Question number 23, sorry. We have a diagram figure 8. It's drawn in isometric. To draw it in oblique cavalier, the dimension y on the receding side is this one. But in cavalier drawing, you don't alter the receding side. You don't alter it. And even if it is cabinet, then we can divide that y by 2, and the answer will become B. But in the case of cavalier drawing, you don't alter it. So the correct answer is A. The correct answer is what? A. Now, question number 24. Question number 24. It says in figure F, figure 9, the true length of the line FG. The true length of the line FG is what? It's FK. By the time you evolve the object, bring it down, what you're going to get? The true length is going to become FK. Many other things there. It's going to become what? FK. I didn't mean a line was drawn from this particular place. And then to this place, we would have talked about something else. But since that line is not drawn, so automatically FK becomes the correct answer. Now we have question, another figure 10. We have to use it to answer question 24, 25 to 27, three questions. Now let's proceed with this. The view R, U, and Y are. The view R, U, and Y. They are what? We are told that they are third angle projections. They are third angle because we are viewing in the direction of the arrow. Look at the diagram given below. You see that the arrow is pointing into the object, meaning the person looking at this object is behind the what he has did. Let me use, for instance, you. The person is standing behind you and is looking at the object. And so what he saw is what is presented as you. Since the what he saw is placed between him and the object he's looking at, it is third angle projection. The correct answer is what? C. When this is the auxiliary projection is which one? Which one is auxiliary? The correct answer is Q. That's the correct answer. Q is auxiliary. No, this answer therefore is B. The end view is nothing but Y. That's looking at this object from the right hand side. The end view is what? Y. Question 28. It says the development of the hexagonal prism shown in figure 11 with axis as seen is what? The correct answer in this case is A. It's A. A is the correct answer. But because this pointed end is going to give us this pointed end, this lower part is going to give us this lower part, and that is it. So the correct answer is A. Number 29, the abbreviation for centers is simply D. The answer is CRS. That's the abbreviation for centers. Number 30, the figure shown above, figure 12 shows the elevation of what? Elevation of a triangular pyramid caught by the section, by the plane, X, Y, Y. So a development is D. No other one here fits this. It's only D that can do that. Because if you join this, you see it here, here, and here. You seem to have the same shape, except here that is a little bit shorter. So accommodating there for this corner that is somewhere around here. So the answer is what? D. And we have come to section D. Section D. Number one, we have to answer building drawing. The truth is that the answer for building drawing in each question and that of machine drawing, the same question, are the same. This is, we have part one, two times, twice. One for building drawing, one for machine drawing. Depending on which one you can answer. So if you are good in building drawing, you are good to go here. If you are good in machine drawing, you are good to go in section B2. That's why they wrote optional here. That's why WAEC is the only body that does that. NECO does not do that. So in this case, let us proceed. Now, we said figure 13 shows the type of door. Use it to answer question 13 and question what? 31 and 32. Now look at that door again. The type of door is what? It's panel door. The answer is A. The answer is A, it's panel door. Number 32, the part labeled Y is what? Is star. This is a star. This place is called the star. The answer is B. Please, you take time and look at this building design. We will answer something that we have here. Alright, so use it to answer 33 to 35. Alright, if the height of each riser is 120, the height X is what? Now look at it. Riser is that part of the step that you have to go up to land on the thread. Alright, for this one there are three risers. And if you are to get in total height informed by just three risers, you can be able to see for three risers, 120 multiplied by what? Three. What do you get? You get 360. But the entire height of the floor, because that's just what the height, the distance of it, is to subtract this 320 from this 360 from 3,100. What do you have? 2,704 millimeters. That means the answer is, the answer here is B. What happened here is that we have three risers actually, so you have to subtract them from the entire given. So this product is incorrect. Question 34. How many threads are formed in the section of the building? Please look at that building again. Where you see that FL, that's floor level, is not a thread. Any place that have floor level does not have thread. But the other one that you have to match your leg on top and match your leg to acquire to reach the another height, is there are two of them. So there are only two threads. The answer here is B. The right answer, correct answer here is B. Now number 35. The portion level M and M respectively are, the answer is C, parapet wall and D, parapet wall and coping. Parapet wall, the wall that used to raise parapet. Okay. The coping is any sheet used to cover the parapet to avoid water from soaking into it and destroying it completely. The answer is D. Now consider the diagram given here again. All right, I'm going to use this diagram and then in figure 15 to show the section of the building. Use to answer 36 to 38. Now the type of wall shown is what? Is cavity wall. The correct answer is C. What you see, look at the diagram, that's a cavity building because there's a hole between the two walls, so it's a cavity wall. Number 37, the part leveled F is a skirting board, because it's called skirting board, only wrote skirt here. Skirt is used to cover rough edges, rough surfaces that the plaster creates at the bottom of the wall. You know, the wall can be smooth, but bottom down there, rubbish. The thing looks very, very ugly in the eye, so they use skirts to cover it. The answer is what? Scared. Get to that number 37. Number 38, the part labeled G is called what? It's DPC, damp proof cause. It's a lean, it's a thin layer that is used to prevent water from coming, reaching the floor surface and then getting this floor spoiled or damaged. For instance, like tile, water gets under it, it can separate and start breaking away. And size C. Question number 39. Figure 16. If the block is 112, length wise, what? They're asking us to find the total distance of this room, of this building from here to here. Please, in taking this kind of account, you pay attention to the first numbers alone. First numbers alone. Okay, these are two numbers, they are all first place. The second one are not given. So in this case, we have to add 4,600 plus this one, 2,800 plus 1,600 plus 1,600 plus then. They say that each of the block is 2, 5 each. And there are five of them. One block, two block, 3, 4, 5. So what do you do? Multiply 225 by 5. Alright? Now say 225 times 5. What do you get? 5 times 3. The answer is 11,725. Yes. Correct. When you add 4,600 plus 2,800 plus 2008 again. In fact, what you're going to get is 10,200. Then add it with 225 multiplied by 3. You're going to get what? 11,725. So the answer is C. That's the correct answer. Number 4, 40. On a building drawing, FA represents the floor line. Nothing more. It's floor line. Now we have finished section part 1 of section B. We are now into part 2 of section B, which is now mechanical drawing. Figure 17 shows dimension of small features. The correct answer is B. It's A. The correct answer is small features. A. Now the symbol for machining a surface is given by a surface without defining the texture of it is B. And size was B. Size B. Now we have to study this question. Use figure 18 to answer question 33 to 35. So we have to use that to answer them. Please look at the diagram again, and then you will see that the section at YY is what? The correct answer is B. Is it? Yes, the correct answer is B. This one has a line here, telling us that there is a line at the other back of the object, which is not true. This one has a line here, telling us that line here, there is a line, as if they welded this one with the other part, which is not true. This one, the same thing, and then the section lines are not there. In fact, this one has a hole here. This one too has a hole, which is a problem, which is not true. The main drawing has a shaft in it. So the correct answer is B. Now the part labeled R is called what? B. The answer is well. Correct answer is well. Right, that's the correct answer. 35. The part level Q. The part that is level Q is what? Is D. The BR. It's a BR. Alright, not pushing. BR. Well, the type of hammer shown in figure 19 is what? Is straight pin hammer. The answer is C. The answer is straight pin hammer. Now, figure 20 shows a type of fastener. Of course, this is a stop used to answer the question 37 and 38. Now, the type of fastener shown is what? The answer is A, stud. I just mentioned it before now. 38, the nominal length is represented by what? It is represented by the part Z. The correct answer is Z. All right. Other measurements do not fall within the nominal word, but of course, length. Nominal length is like the entire length of the object. So the answer is what is Z. Use this question, this figure to answer question 39 and 40. All right, question. The portion level M and N respectively are what? The correct answer here is chamfer and undercut, not recess. Chamfer and under. The answer is C. Chamfer and what? Undercut. Now, number 40. The machine surface on the portion P is what? It's null. It's null. Null surface is null. So, this is what you have as the answer for the entire question. Oh, it doesn't know what. 18. We have now modified it and upgraded it to make it accessible and more accurate for us. Please, if this thing has blessed you, share this video, like this video, subscribe to the channel if you have not done that. Click the notification button to enable you to see whenever I upload any other new video. Thank you for listening and may God see you through in the WAEC exam that you're facing. Thank you and God bless you.